Ukrainian forces strike one of the few bridges linking Crimea to Ukraine, cutting a main supply route for Russian occupation forces. The bridge is just one of a handful of access roads to the peninsula, with alternative routes requiring hours-long detours. Now, Moscow has yet to comment on the strike, but it is unlikely to be seen as a major setback for their forces. Now, the bridge is beyond the range of battlefield rockets Ukraine has used for a year, but within reach of newly deployed weapons such as British and French air-launched cruise missiles. This will allow Kyiv to hit logistics routes Russia had deemed safe weeks ago. Now, Ukraine is attacking Russian supply lines to disrupt Moscow's defense of occupied territory in the south, where Kyiv is in the early stages of its most ambitious counteroffensive of the year.
A massive international search for a missing submersible ends after debris from the vessel is found on the ocean floor. An unmanned deep-sea robot discovered the wreckage of the Titan a few hundred meters from the bow of the Titanic, which it had set out to explore. The five people aboard included British billionaire Hamish Harding, Pakistani-born business magnate Shahzada Dawood and his son Suleiman, French oceanographer Paul-Henri Narjoli, and Stockton Rush, the American founder and CEO of OceanGate, which was piloting the submersible. The sweeping search covered more than 10,000 square miles of ocean and involved rescue teams from several countries.
The debris field is consistent with a catastrophic implosion of the vessel. Again, while we were prosecuting the search, we had listening devices in the water throughout and did not hear any signs of catastrophic failure from those. And so we're going to continue to investigate or we're going to continue to document the information there and understand, based on all the information we have, the timeline.
A scientist and journalist who dived to the Titanic wreckage two decades ago, now calling for all trips to the site to be suspended until the cause of the Titan's failure is determined.
We need to put a stop to all trips to the Titanic. This is what we did when the Shuttle Challenger exploded. We shut down the entire U.S. space program. We need to do at least that now. Whether we find the vessel and determine what went wrong with this vessel, we need to stop, pause, take a deep breath, and ask people this question. Why do you want to go to the Titanic, and how do you get there safely?
It isn't just central banks hitting pause. The World Bank is planning to introduce a pause mechanism for debt payments to crisis-hit nations. It's just one of a raft of measures announced by the global lender at a summit on climate change financing in Paris.
Today, we are announcing a comprehensive approach that significantly expands the World Bank's toolkit for crisis preparedness, response, and recovery. What are we going to do? First, help governments build advanced emergency systems so they are ready to respond on day one. Two, provide new types of insurance that will backstop development projects, and most importantly, offer a pause in debt repayments so countries can focus on what matters to their leaders when a crisis hits and stop worrying about the bill that's going to come with that crisis.
The need to reform the global financial system to tackle climate change is one of the central issues in the two-day summit for a new global financing pact. The gathering, attended by some 40 leaders, including from Africa and China, aims to create roadmaps for the next 18 to 24 months, ranging from debt relief to climate finance.
A new era in U.S.-Indian relations, with new deals on defense and commerce aimed at countering China's global influence. At a press conference with Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, President Joe Biden lauded the partnership between Washington and New Delhi, adding the friendship would only grow moving forward.
And today, we also talked about our shared efforts to mitigate the humanitarian tragedies unleashed by Russia's brutal war in Ukraine, and to defend the core principles of the UN Charter's sovereignty and territorial integrity.
Modi, meanwhile, touted what he calls a new chapter to the country's strategic partnership after talks between their differences on Russia and human rights were on the table. But when asked about the steps he's willing to take to improve the rights of Muslims and other minorities in his country, Modi insisted nothing needed to be improved. Democratic lawmakers had urged Biden to raise the issue of human rights with the Indian leader.
Biden is still expecting to meet the Chinese leader Xi Jinping soon. This despite his comment likening Xi to a dictator, which has drawn sharp criticism from Beijing. The remark came shortly after U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken's trip to Beijing to repair bilateral relations. But Biden doesn't think his comment has undermined or complicated relations with China.
Secretary Blinken had a great trip to China. I expect to be meeting with President Xi sometime in the future. The near term, and I don't think it's had any real consequence.
A U.S. Coast Guard ship sailed through the Taiwan Strait on Tuesday, just a day after Blinken's Beijing visit. The U.S. Navy says the transit was routine and that the ship was exercising its right to freedom of navigation in accordance with international law. The politically sensitive strait is a frequent source of tension as Beijing steps up its political and military pressure to try to force Taipei to accept Chinese sovereignty. The Chinese Coast Guard describes the transit as public hype, noting its vessels sailed the American ship all the way. U.S. military vessels and on occasion, those of its allies have routinely sailed through the strait in recent years, to the anger of China, which views such missions as provocation.
Let's now check out the latest stories from our North America Bureau with our correspondent, Penny Espinosa.
Good morning, guys. Here are the latest stories making headlines amongst the Filipino community.
We begin in Las Vegas, where some housekeepers are worried for their jobs after Nevada Governor Joe Lombardo signed Senate Bill 441, which eliminates a requirement for daily hotel room cleanings. The law says that district boards of health adopted regulations requiring certain protocols and plans concerning SARS-CoV-2 and COVID-19. Longtime housekeeper Elena Newman fears she won't make enough money and won't be able to support her family back in the Philippines.
There will be a massive layoff dahil kung check out lang ang lilinisin, di ba? Kung check lang ang lilinisin, daming lilinisin ang occupied, maraming workers mawawalan ng trabaho. And not only that, kulang hours namin, mawawalan kami ng health insurance, which is very expensive.
In sports, a group of global Filipinos are cranking it back and letting it rip at World Lacrosse Men's Championship in San Diego this week. The Philippine national team is among 30 teams from around the world competing, and they're ready to bring Philippine lacrosse to the next level.
It feels amazing to be out here with this group of guys representing our country, playing to defend our spot. You know, we finished top 10 in 2018, and we're looking for a strong finish this time around the World Games as well.
That 2018 10th place finish was the Philippine Lacrosse Association's World Championship competition debut after being created in 2013. While lacrosse is North America's oldest game, it's fairly new to Filipinos. Highly decorated Filipino-American competitors make up a majority of the Philippine team, like Texas native Dan Morris, who won a college national championship with the University of Maryland before playing professionally in the Premier Lacrosse League. Team Philippines begins its quest for gold on Friday against Israel. And finally, in entertainment news, 16-time Grammy Award-winning musician, composer, and producer David Foster, Catherine McPhee, acclaimed singer, television, and Broadway star, and Martin Nievera, the concert king of the Philippines, are coming together for two nights of music at the Wynn Hotel's Encore Theater on June 23 and 24.
He said, "Hey, I'm going to be in Las Vegas. If you're there, I would love for you to be with us. And I happen to be here. So I'll be there. That's on June 23 and 24 at the Wynn. David Foster and some of his favorite singers and one Filipino guy.
Our dear friend Martin Nevera, you remember him.
Oh, my gosh. Forever in you.
Right.
Forever in you.
But what a voice he has.
Yeah, he's amazing.
When we touch... when the one you light the fire.
I'm so happy because hopefully if he likes what I do it enough for me to join him at the Win on June 23 and 24, that means the door is now open for other Filipino artists, younger, older.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Back to you guys for the rundown.